Welcome back, everybody. Winnipeg in town. Andre Pavlik, who was outstanding on Saturday night in a loss, in the 1-0 loss in Tampa, he gets the start tonight.
And the Panthers trying to do something that's never been done here against him. He's won all three starts here in Sunrise. Panthers trying to break that streak. Jose Theodore back in nets after a good game in Buffalo where he stopped 24 of 26 shots in the 3-2 victory.
Let's get to our keys to tonight's game. What do you got, Billy?
Some home cooking. You got to be good on home ice. Dineen looking for separation here at home. Puck management, smart plays with the puck. And offense from defense. Kevin Dineen said a lot of the offensive chances they've created from being good, sound, positionally, defensively. So look for that tonight.
Intense to get things started. And South Florida gets another crack at the Jets this fall. So here we go. First of six meetings between these two teams. Our puck drop in high definition is presented by H.H. Gregg. And Garrison moves back behind his own net with Wellwood. Played to the corner. The veteran Kyle Wellwood gives it to the captain, Andrew Ladd. Out in front, Ryan Campbell picked it off. And around for Garrison, but too far. Wellwood will step up. And the Jets on the opening shift in the Florida zone. Ryan Campbell with those 9 assists this season. He has been outstanding. Here comes Campbell, has Fleischman up ahead. He moves in, holds and shoots, and Pavlik steers it to the corner. Weiss around for Versteeg. This Panther top line has been nothing short of sensational this year.
There were some worries about chemistry coming into the start of the season, but that has not been the case with that number one line. They got it going right from the start in game one, and they have never relented.
The Gotch line now on for Florida. Thomas Kopetsky and Upshaw on the wings. Kopetsky off a 3-assist night in Buffalo. And here he comes in the offensive zone out in front. Carried wide. Gotch will track it down and they give to Scotty Upshaw. Up to the point, Kulikov. Now Gotch cuts it off. Hit hard behind the net. He went down.
Kopetsky was mentioned by Kevin Dineen as being the really spark in Buffalo. Really got him over the hump in that 3-2 victory.
Icing the call here.
And behind the bench, Claude Noel, his first season, and he says he's still starting to learn his team, not sure about their strengths and weaknesses, but it has been an up-and-down start for the Winnipeg Jets. He set a goal of 96 points, and Kevin Dineen, after that most complete effort he called in Buffalo, looking for a repeat performance here on home ice.
Santarelli on with Skilly and Sturm. Mike Santarelli's first home game this year, came back from the shoulder injury on the road trip last week. He and his line mates creating a lot of scoring chances. Spoke to him this morning. Said, yeah, we're getting lots of chances. And here they come with Skilly moving in, looking for a chance. They've got some speed, Skilly, Santarelli, and Marco Sturm. Santarelli for Jovanovski. The blast pinballs to the corner. Now behind the net. Picked up by Skilly. Holding. Centering pass has a man. The Sturm shot is deflected and goes wide. There is this Santarelli line pushing things offensively.
They've created a lot of chances. They just have not figured in a lot of the scoring. Jack Skilly actually second on the team in shots with 26 and still does not have a goal on the season. So they're getting pucks to the net. You'd think eventually they will get rewarded.
Skilly cruising through center. And then he'll slide it deep into the zone. End of a shift for him. Panthers still have Sean Bergenheim, Michael Samuelson, who's yet to play a game after the trade from Vancouver, and Scott Clemenson. All out of lineup with injury. Keaton Ellerby is the healthy scratch. Bergenheim and Clemenson both skated this morning, so they're getting better.
I'm not sure what to expect from this Winnipeg team.
Antropov. That one deflects and goes wide. Yeah, they won a game 9-8 two games ago.
And they lost 1-0 last game in Tampa Bay, so they've been all over the spectrum and a lot of inconsistencies, and that's really bothered their coach, Claude Noel.
Of course, Panthers assistant Craig Ramsey was the coach of this team last year when they were in Atlanta. Here's Kopetsky ahead of the field, but the lead pass and a good look from Campbell was deflected away, and now a whistle and a stoppage on an offside. 3 minutes in, we are scoreless here at the Bank Atlantic Center on the Lexus Rink. A lot of home games coming up this month for the Panthers, including the Thanksgiving Feast Week. Four big games, Saturday against Pittsburgh, Monday the Devils, the night before Thanksgiving the Rangers, the night after Tampa, and then the Hot 105 Love Train Concert Saturday night. 954-835-PUCK. What a week that's going to be. With Branson able to lift it all the way down, and this will be on net. And Pavlik, with Matthias charging, has to cover up and hold for a whistle.
And one not to get lost in this season, the job that Kevin Dineen has been able to do early on, and I really like his calm and poise. The tough loss in Ottawa, he was calm after the game and didn't like what happened, but he didn't really lay into his teammates. And I think 19 years of playing in the NHL, he knows it's a long season, and his team responded extremely well in Buffalo. Kevin Dineen has done an exceptional job handling his team early in the season.
And what he did was a 45-minute kind of tutorial on their systems the next day, Friday in Buffalo, and responded with an outstanding game. Gudbranson got that shot through. So does Jovanovski. Loose in front. Mathias is stopped by Pavlik. Three straight shots. The best chance was for Mathias. Pavlik was up to the task. And another shot by Jovanovski.
And that started from a face-off win. And the Panthers have improved in the face-off circle. And this time it's Matt Bradley, the winger, and it's just a quick shot from Gudbranson. And good recognition by Jovanovski, and Mathias was able to elude his man. Three shots, good rebound opportunities. That's what you need against Pavlik. You have to be able to get second shots. Panthers did that off the one faceoff.
Faceoff win for Weiss. Kulikov tees it up, and it just goes wide. Weaver for Weiss. Moves it in deep for Versteeg. Out in front looking for Fleischman. Tipped away. Good defensive work by Wellwood. Weiss on the back check. Tuck carries in behind the net. Kulikov took a hit, but got it around the boards. Now Andrew Ladd sends it out in front, the shot, and they score! Ladd sets up Wellwood, and just like that, the Jets have the lead.
Wellwood right in the middle of the slot, puts the Jets in front, 1-0. Kulikov got back to get the puck, and the pinch down by the defenseman enables the play to get in, and you can see some confusion in the own end. They're trying to scramble, look around for men. No one picks up Wellwood. It's right on his stick, and it's in the back of the net. So a scrambly play in front of Theodore. The perfectly placed shot, and the Jets have the lead.
Wellwood having a rebirth in Winnipeg. Five goals now on the season, and the captain, Andrew Ladd, who was teammates with Brian Campbell, Chris Versteeg, and Kopetsky in Chicago, and they won that cup. And he gets the assist. Play in the Panther zone here. Bermistroff, the 20-year-old, the 8th overall pick last year in the draft. Antropov trying to hold it in the zone. Kane now throws it towards the net. It bounced on Theodore. He made the stop. A little momentum for the Jets. This is Bermistroff at the goal line. He'll walk up the wall and cycle it back in deep. Kane, sharp angle shot deflected by Garrison, and that'll carry up and out of play for a whistle. So the lead early on for Winnipeg. The Panthers are back home. Tell you, Brooklyn Water Bagel Company is under new management of the Saveology.com Iceplex. Fresh baked bagels, variety of sandwiches. They're open 8 to 8 at the Saveology.com Iceplex. You can eat in or take out. Stewart got the second assist on the goal. Point shot, never got through. Weiss trying to clear it out. Brian Little strong on the puck. Here's Wellwood again, stolen by Kulikov. And the Panthers will break out. Kulikov ahead for Fleischman, got a stick on it, and it comes all the way around the boards. Johnny Oduya had it stolen away by Versteeg, but the centering pass came up to Little. Ryan Little carrying in, has some help in Oduya. This drop pass and the slap shot is stopped by Theodore. Oduya again, a former Devil, came over in the Kovalchuk deal.
Got to make sure you get back against the defenseman. Panthers late getting back. Oduya able to get the slap shot. So the Panthers a little lackadaisical in their defensive responsibilities early in the first.
First of a three-game homestand. Chicago's in Thursday and then Tampa on Sunday at 5 o'clock. Thorburn, centering pass. Good D there by Sturm. There was a man open in front. Now Tanner Glass, though, finds a loose puck. He's off to a hot offensive start. One-time Panther, draft pick, Glass is, and was, ninth rounder. Here's Glass tapping it back to the point. Dustin Bufflin winds and fires, and that was blocked down in front. Hit his own man. Slater is down. He took that puck hard. Meanwhile, Sturm breaks out, and he'll shoot in.
Dustin Bufflin's got a heavy shot, and it looked to catch Slater in the ankle. He gingerly goes to the bench.
That'll hurt. We'll keep an eye on 19 and White. Blake Wheeler flying into the offensive zone. Centering feed tipped by Campbell. Now Kendall McCardle wearing 23, a former Panther, a first-round pick. Traded during the offseason. McCardle battling in the corner. Stapleton hit by Garrison. Stapleton maintains possession. Point shot, never got through. It was blocked by Garrison. Kennedy, nice feed up ahead. Bradley looking for Matthias, it's blocked. Bradley gets it back. Now Matthias, hands to Kennedy. Matthias in the corner, plays it up high. Campbell holding. His little float shot got deflected, but the Panthers back on it. Matthias again, working along the boards, played it behind the net. Zach Bogosian there for Winnipeg. All the way down it comes on goal, so no icing.
That's exactly where that fourth line has to play, down deep in the trenches. They will win some battles, don't get any pucks to the net, but that's where they will be effective against that defense corps. That's what you need from your fourth line. They need to grind it out down in the corners.
Dmitry Kulikov off to a really strong start this year. Lost that puck to Antropov. And Theodore is going to smother this one. With 12:40 to go in the opening period, the Jets have the lead on Halloween night. They're having fun here in Sunrise.
Back at the Bank Atlantic Center on the Lexus Rink on a Halloween night. A Kyle Wellwood goal has the Winnipeg Jets up on top of the Florida Panthers 1-0 here in the first period of play. I'm Frank Fort along with Steve Goldstein and Billy Lindsay. Our Service America plan of the game, it comes from the head coach Kevin Dineen talking about the 6-4 start. He says, we seem to have generated a lot of offense and it started with good defense, getting into our transition and taking advantage of the speedy players that we have. And Billy and Goldie, I think we've seen a lot of that so far this season. And it's here the Panthers trying to use their speed, especially out of the back end. Campbell and Garrison have shown really good offensive abilities in getting the team moving through the neutral zone. Guys?
Thanks, Frank. This top line, Weiss, Versteeg, and Fleischmann in the offensive zone. It's Versteeg holding, handing it over to Campbell. He cuts down low. Campbell hit by Ladd, but he gave it away. Fleischmann finds Garrison. Here's a shot. A big stop by Pavlik again, who's been sharp early on. Panthers have had some good pressure. Little into the offensive zone for Ladd. Back for Little. He couldn't tee up the backhander. Nifty play again by Andrew Ladd, who set up the first goal of the game. The only one so far by Wellwood. Now Campbell has some room. Campbell to the Winnipeg line. Gives to Fleischmann. Backhander was deflected, came all the way through the boards. Vermistrov, lead pass for Kane. Drop pass, Stewart, slap shot. Theodore will hold on.
Panthers have to be careful. The defense for the Winnipeg Jets are activating, and the wingers for the Panthers are late getting back. And another shot from the defenseman. So if you're a winger on the forwards, you got to make sure you come back and against those defensemen, try and take away those slap shots. Winnipeg Jets getting a lot of shots against Theodore from the back end.
Panthers have won three of their last four games. Each one of them, or the last three I should say, have all been decided by a goal. The fourth has scored an empty netter, so in essence a one goal game. It's been exciting. Gotch working in behind his own net defensively, plays it up the boards. Ooh, Upshaw with a big hit there, and they're going to get him for a penalty on Kane. And Stewart comes over to Upshaw. Those two have some words. Weaver in there as well.
And it wasn't the official close to the play that made the call. It was the official out in the center ice area. Kind of strange that the official close to the play didn't make the call against Upshaw. The problem was that the puck was kind of in the vicinity, but it wasn't on the stick of Kane. It was there, but not really, and you could see the blow, and it's up close to the head. And you got to be careful with the new rules.
So Scotty Upshaw, who's been a physical player for the Panthers so far this year, gets called for an elbow there.
It wasn't so much an elbow, but it was
more an interference.
A shoulder interference.
Yeah, okay. In any event, it's the first power play of the game. And the Panthers penalty kill will try to go to work here and kill it off. Brought to us by Ace Underwriting. Enstrom is up at the point. And now Ladd on the boards. Tobias Enstrom, a good offensive player. Little centering pass, a touch pass for Ladd. Then they go over to Buckland. They couldn't get a shot away. Enstrom now shoots wide. Perhaps one pass too many by the Jets that time. Enstrom holds it in. And Little feeds down low, out in front again. Wellwood, good work there by Garrison, but knocked down by Little. And back for Enstrom again. His slap shot rises high. Wellwood blocked by Weaver. But Andrew Ladd tracks it down, goes behind Theodore's net. Little plays it up high. Enstrom for Little again. And down low one more time. Out in front, defected by Buckland, who's right there in front. It's a big man in front of Theodore's net.
And quick puck movement by the Jets, and a positive concern for the Panthers. They've given up a power play goal in six of the last seven games and try and stay in that tight box, but two forwards up top. When you're playing on the penalty kill and you've been struggling, just stay in your position, keep it compact. You see the Panthers started to run around, and that quick passing started to turn the heads of the Panthers.
One thing the Jets do have is a lot of talent. A number of high first-round picks and playing on their team. In fact, of the 40 players between the two teams tonight, 19 first-round picks are in this game. Add in seven more second-rounders as well. Antropov got it through up to the point. Zach Bogosian, his slap shot goes high. Antropov tracks it down. Weiss and Jovanovski are on him. But it's taken back the other way, and a shot, and they score! Free puck picked up by Kane, and now it's 2-0 Winnipeg.
And Versteeg had a chance in the middle of the ice. He tried to carry the puck out, got it poked off his stick, and Evander Kane puts it behind Theodore. And the Panthers, number 32 in the middle of your screen, Chris Versteeg going to have it on his stick. As it comes around, then good pressure by Jovanovski. Right here is the play on the stick. It's got to be hard, and it's got to be off the boards. Chris Versteeg tried to carry it out of the zone, created the turnover. And when you're struggling to kill penalties, just keep it simple. Get the pucks down the ice, and Evander Kane jumps on it. 2-0 for the Jets.
So the Panthers here behind the eight ball, 10 minutes into the game. Good news for the Cats. There is plenty of time left. 2-0. And to Branson at the point. They give to Skilly. Fends off the check. Takes a shot from the sharp angle. Another shot by Santarelli. And Pavlik with two more saves. He's 3-0 here in South Florida in his career with a 1.63 goals against. He's been outstanding against the Panthers. To Branson holds it in. The shot was blocked and it carries to center. Brian Campbell resets the offense. Intended pass, you hear the linesman yelling no, no, meaning no icing. Panthers get a line change. Jose Theodore will play this around the boards. Scooped up by Kennedy. Mathias moving with speed, but the pass was in his skates.
And after an extended road trip, a lot of times this game back at home is a tough one, and for the Panthers, a sluggish start.
Wheeler, who negated the icing, sends it right out in front. It came through the goal mouth. Mathias. Around for Weaver. Stewart at the point. Keeps it alive. Weaver again. Wheeler steals away. Weaver staying right with Blake Wheeler. Stapleton now joins in. Back again. Wheeler trying to get out in front with a puck. Couldn't do it. And Kulikov, a little poke check. He played it up the boards for Kennedy. And the Panthers clear the zone. 2-0 Winnipeg here in the first. And Kulikov, both teams get some new personnel on the ice. Stolen away in the neutral zone, Kyle Wellwood. Locked down by Weiss. Those two battle at the Panther line. And Versteeg. Lead pass, out of the reach of Fleischman. Icing call on the Panthers.
And for the Panthers, time to regroup, get your thoughts together, and after that big victory in Buffalo, you thought maybe that the momentum would swing over into this home game against the Jets, but tonight the Jets desperate early, and they've won the puck battles and some softy play. We talked about puck management as being one of the keys, and the Panthers have not had it.
Point shot there by Buffalo went wide. Versteeg up to center, a little touch pass. Campbell picks up. Puts it to the wing again. Versteeg, he poked it in behind the net, tracks it down there. He's double-teamed, and he steals it away. Good work by Versteeg, and then he gets hit hard and goes down. And Buckland has it for the Jets. Enstrom's lead pass, tracked down by Little. Sends it out in front, has a man, but backhander is stopped. It was Kane again, cruising in front of the net. Boy, Winnipeg is skating and creating some good chances in front. Ooh, and Fleischman gets a high stick, and that's a penalty.
So the Panthers get a chance on the power play.
Delayed call here. Theodore will get to the bench. Panthers have the extra man on. Looking for a chance here on the delayed penalty. Kopetsky will circle back.
Heads up, right here on the line.
And now for Brian Campbell, but again, that pass just didn't quite connect, and we do get the whistle. Florida power play is coming up after Jose Theodore makes a big stop to keep it at 2-0. Panthers going to get a power play chance to cut that lead in half. Before we start that, let's get to our Geico quote of the game from Panthers goalie Jose Theodore. On Jacob Markstrom, Theodore said, "I was so happy to see him get in there and do well. One of my jobs here is to help him and try to mentor him." Class act, Jose Theodore. Of course, Markstrom at age 21 had big night last Monday in Montreal. Started a couple of games in a row. Theodore there to support him. Good to see. Gotch on the offensive zone draw on the power play. And Marcel Gotch controls. Back for Garrison. He and Jovanovski will start at the point on the man advantage. Here's Kopetsky along the boards. Now Gotch. Santarelli's on as well. Gotch shifts it back for Garrison. Now down low. Jovanovski out in front. Comes back to Garrison. Gotch again. Little different look here on the man advantage for the Panthers. Gotch at the dot. Shooting. Locked down. Carries to the point. Garrison again keeps it alive. Kopetsky down low. Poked away by Enstrom. Kopetsky battling. Keeps it alive. Santarelli picks it up. Back again, Garrison. Good work here by the Panthers. Kopetsky faked the shot. Jovanovski is now camped out in front. There's the shot at the flex. Out of play. .107 to go in the Panther power play. As they get some new players on. Today's Saveology deal will make you smile. Pearly whites can be yours for $40 with Lightning Smiles Mini Teeth Whitening Kit. Plus a bonus touch-up pen, $139 value. Go to Saveology.com. Now it's the starting power play unit, the first unit, if you will, out for Florida. And Kulikov gloves it down. Versteeg with Fleischman and Weiss. Campbell up high. Kulikov again. Campbell winds and fires. It was blocked down in front, and then Pavlik got a shoulder on it. Deflected on net. Pavlik got it up high. Weiss back again. Kulikov has a lane. Moving in. Shooting was deflected, though, before it ever got to the net. Flipped the other way. Look out. Thorburn trying to track it down, but he's in the corner. And the Panthers quickly go over to him. But Thorburn was able to unload it to Bogosian.
Good start for the Winnipeg goaltender, Pavlik. 9 shots for the Panthers there. That one up high. Only 6 shots for the Jets. So Pavlik, a good story early for the Jets.
Versteeg shifting over the line, but lost the puck. Garrison resets. Panthers looking for one more rush on the man advantage, led by Campbell. Point shot, Garrison. He ripped it wide. Carries to the wall. Garrison knocks it down. And now Weiss, but it's past him. Campbell picks it up. Garrison winds, fakes the shot. They give to Versteeg. Out in front, deflected into the high slot. And out of the penalty box is Bufflin. And he breaks into the Panther zone. Tries to make a move in front. Campbell there to clean up. Panthers run the other way. Tipped in deep by Bradley. Pavlik around the boards. Blocked down by Bradley. Mathias digs it out. Has a man in Jovanovski at the line. Weaver for Mathias. Wheels it out in front. Stick save by Pavlik. Mathias again. Hits solidly by Bufflin. It rolls side of the net. And Pavlik will smother it for a whistle. 4.5 to go in the opening period of the Jets. Lead by 2. Back at the Bank Atlantic Center on the Lexus Rink. The Jets have the early 2-0 lead here in the first. Coming up at our first intermission, Allison Williams will discuss the Chicago 3 led by Brian Campbell, who came over in the offseason to the Panthers. I'll go one-on-one with the rookie, Eric Goodbranson, and Billy will have the breakdown of the first. All just ahead with 4:29 to go here in the first period. Winnipeg up 2-0. Kyle Wellwood got the first goal, and Evander Kane the second. Offensive zone, Panthers win the draw, and Skilly sweeps in behind the net. Up for Goodbranson, but he fanned on the shot attempt, and Bufflin will carry out. He's a big man, he's got some offensive skills. Actually, that was McCardle, 23, the former Panther. And Jovanovski will track it down in the corner. Jovanovski paired up with Eric Goodbranson, who will be with the Panthers all season long. They made that announcement the other day. Jovanovski, cross ice. Skilly looking to get by Johnny Oduya. Couldn't. Santarelli there to find a loose puck. Now the Panthers get it deep and they'll go for a change. Randy Jones, the veteran defenseman. Feed up to center. Ladd carries in, takes a shot, stick by Theodore.
In a 2-0 game, all of a sudden that next goal becomes vitally important. Has to fall on the stick of the Panthers. You don't want to fall behind 3-0.
Weiss cutting in. Finds Fleischman with a shot, a deflected over the net. Versteeg at the goal line took a swipe at it. Now he's got it in the corner, but Enstrom closed on him and took it away. Panthers have created offense. They've got 11 shots, but Pavlik has been outstanding, as he has been throughout his career against the Panthers.
And I think the same thing that you did in Buffalo applies tonight. Just stick with the game plan. Stick with getting shots.
Puck up and out of play. 3 minutes to go in the period. Fans, have you joined the Redvolution? Be part of South Florida's biggest fan movement. Exclusive content, special events, and more. Go to jointherevolution.com and be part of the Redvolution. The Panthers with the red seats now in the lower bowl here at the Bank Atlantic Center, the Lexus Rink. The red jerseys, the new slash old red jerseys. And the Panthers opening a three-game homestand here tonight. Good hit by Kopetsky. Loose puck picked up and the shot deflects wide off the stick of Upshaw. Kopetsky again. Now Campbell gives it to Upshaw. Out in front, Gotch has a chance. Glove save, rebound, another chance. It's blocked down and Pavlik is down. The Panthers trying to get a stick on it. Campbell for Upshaw. More good chances for Florida. But the Jets will escape again.
And they've had some rebound opportunities. Pavlik, brilliant.
Bogosian takes a shot wide. And Kopetsky throws it on net. Stick save by Pavlik.
And if you're the Panthers, you're sitting on the bench and you're just saying to yourselves, keep doing this, keep putting pressure, keep getting shots towards the goaltender. They're starting to build momentum.
Panthers get a steal there, and Jovanovski sees some open ice. Gets up to center. Finds Mathias. Knocked off his stick. Bouncing out in front. Bradley battles. Able to play it. Back for Jovanovski. Good Branson. Little shot on goal. Gets through. Pavlik is down. The wraparound attempt, and it stays out of the net. Mathias again out in front. The shot and a save by Pavlik on Kennedy. Panthers all over the Winnipeg net. Finally settled down by Oduya. Florida now up to 15 shots on goal here in the first. The Jets have iced the puck.
Some more desperation after that second goal by the Jets. Again, Campbell stepping down. The defenseman, he is trouble every time he steps the ice, and the glove save, and that's what you want. You want those second chances and all kinds of traffic around the goaltender, and this started from a point shot from Goodbranson. Panthers getting bodies, getting pucks towards the net, and those are shifts you can build off of.
Here's Weiss now, looking for Versteeg, knocked away. Campbell with a hit. Panthers keep it in the zone. Weiss has a jump under his stick, though. And Weiss able to settle it down. Cross ice Campbell. Now Garrison, the big blast. Pavlik with the save. To the rebound, the shot deflects wide off the stick of Fleischman. Weiss again. Finds Versteeg, and he hammers a one-timer high. Campbell back down low. Fleischman behind the net. Tied up. Got it free to Campbell. Garrison again with a one-timer. That was blocked by Glass. Campbell on the loose puck along the boards. Up for Versteeg. Panthers all over the Jets late in the period. Campbell cross ice Garrison. Versteeg again. That one deflects wide. Campbell on the pinch one more time for Fleischman. Looking out in front. Goes to the point for Garrison. Panthers are not on the power play here, in case you're wondering. Garrison with another blast. He scores! Bang! With 20 seconds to go in the period, Garrison does it again.
A dominant shift from the Panthers and another long-range elephant gun blast by Jason Garrison. And you can see the momentum building from the Panthers. A couple of shifts down in the offensive zone, and then this number one line for Versteeg, Fleischman, and Weiss, they just come out and control the puck for about 40 seconds, and it ends up with a long-range bomb. But that was just simply a result of hard work. They were relentless on the puck. The Jets unable to get the puck out of the zone, and they were dead tired. The Winnipeg Jets were out of gas. They had been out there in their own zone chasing the puck around for about 45, 50 seconds. And finally, the Panthers on the board.
20 shots in the period for the Panthers. Garrison leads all NHL defensemen with 5 goals. Weaver shot wide. Kulikov, he'll take a shot deflected over the net by Skilly. And the Panthers come on strong in that first period after Winnipeg took a 2-0 lead. Garrison's 5th of the season. He has tied his career high already. He had 5 all of last season, and the Panthers only down a goal after the first.
And it was an important goal after falling down 2-0. Panthers with some sloppy play early in the first period, but you could see it. The Panthers get a couple of good offensive zone shifts. They start to get some chances against Pavlik, and finally some perseverance results in a goal by Jason Garrison, and this was a marvelous shift by that number one line. The Winnipeg Jets just never get the puck, and you can see how tired the Jets are. They're just all straight-legged. They can't even move anymore, and no one has a harder shot than Jason Garrison. You just don't beat goaltenders from that far out without having a heavy, heavy shot. And again, it's his defense partner, Brian Campbell, who sets it up on a tee. Pavlik down in the butterfly. Garrison goes upstairs. Help from Fleischman, and this is where the troubles begin for the Winnipeg Jets as this number one line is able to dominate. Here's the one chance they had to clear the puck, but Campbell steps down, and that really cost the Jets. The Panthers were able to keep the puck in, and then it's just domination from there. Puck control, the passes are right on the stick. The shot against Pavlik, and good puck retrieval, and Winnipeg just running around. This is later in the shift, and what I'm going to show you, just roll it a bit. And just puck control. What you're going to see, stop here. Look at the straight legs of all the Winnipeg players. Dead tired. You can watch. They're trying to stay in that box. But watch, no movement by the Jets. They cannot move. Those are dead tired hockey players. As they're just trying to stay in that compact zone. They can't even move their legs or feet anymore. Just trying to keep it down in front of the goaltender. But the laser beam at the end from Garrison is too much.
Let's get to our numbers in the opening period. Lexus brings us the first period stats, and there it is, a season high. 20 shots on goal for the Panthers, who at least after Winnipeg took the 2-0 lead, the Panthers really started dominating, and they'll hope to carry that into the second period.
And this is a Winnipeg team that gives up 3.5 goals per game. It's 29th in the NHL, so a team that gives up a lot of goals. If you're the Panthers, continue the way you finished that first period.
So the Panthers have some guys picking up some numbers. There's a look at Pavlik, who made 19 saves in the first period. Thomas Fleischman of the Panthers is now riding the 5-game point streak. Theodore, the goal for the Panthers, and there's our game summary. We look at the ebbs and flows. Check that out. A streaky game so far, and the Panthers will hope they're on the plus side of the streak. Jason Garrison, by the way, with the goal, now has a 3-game goal streak. His 5 goals lead all NHL defensemen. Brian Campbell now, 10 assists, tied for the second most in the NHL.
Garrison, 5 goals. Campbell's assisted on every single goal. Quite a pair.
Race is on, and Bufflin did get there first, so an early icing call on Florida 11 seconds into the period.
And for the Winnipeg Jets, this is an important part of their season. 3-6-1, they are in the midst of a 7-game road trip. This is the 3rd game for Claude Noel and his team. This is a make-or-break point, so desperation for the Jets. Expect them to come out a little bit better for the Panthers. Just continue to do what made you successful in that first period.
Looks like they're staying here in Florida till Wednesday before going up to New York. Bufflin Flyers, and save made by Theodore, and then Thursday they'll play the Islanders, and then the Devils, the Rangers, and the Sabres before finally going back to Winnipeg for the game against the Panthers next Thursday night. We'll be there for the first time in a very long time back in Winnipeg.
And they're excited to have hockey back in Winnipeg. It's been a long time since 1996.
Now what am I looking at, November 10th? We're going to get snow and 10 degrees, or how are we looking up there?
You bring your toque, all right, and your parka, and your long johns, everything that you can find.
That's hat, coat, and underwear for those of you who didn't get the vernacular. Ladd moves in, deflected wide by Little. Wellwood has one of the goals tonight, lost it to Weiss. Ryan Campbell slides it ahead, Fleischman tracks it down. And he'll swing it up ahead through Versteeg. Bufflin around the boards. Atlanta got, or in Winnipeg, I knew it was going to happen. Winnipeg got two goals in the opening 10 minutes. Wellwood and Kane. Panthers answered back with just 20 seconds left in the first on the Garrison goal.
It does give you pause for thought because you see all the same players that you saw for many years in Atlanta. Just with a new name and new team.
Well, you feel good for the city of Winnipeg. They're supporting their team, but you also at the same time feel real bad for the fans in Atlanta. Bogosian, nifty move there. Here's Kane. Cross ice. Scotch got a stick on it, but it carried through to Antropov. His shot right on, and Theodore will hold it. 1:20 into the second period. Jingle Ball is coming back to the Bank Atlantic Center Saturday, December 10th. A great lineup featuring Pitbull and more. Tickets are on sale, 800-745-3000. One of the many great events here at the Bank Atlantic Center. Sent all the way down, and the Panthers are going to ice the puck again. So the draw will come back one more time.
And Kevin Dineen, a lot goes back, and some of the best coaches that I played for, Roger Nielsen, Doug McLean, they were saying they were calm, and they just knew the process. Stick with the process. Stick with the process. They kept preaching that. Their panic level was low, and that seems to be the case with Kevin Dineen, and you could see it in the Buffalo game. They stayed with it, got the win at the end, and the same thing tonight. Give up the two early goals, but not a lot of panic from the Panthers. Stuck with their systems and got the momentum headed in the right direction.
Jets have come out much better here in the second than the way they ended the first. Yeah, at least in the opening minute 40. Now a turnover, the Panther line, and Gotch starts the other way, leaves it for Kopetsky. The shot was blocked. Upshaw tracks it down. That was blocked by Bogosian. Upshaw with a good bump there on Bogosian, who's shaken up from blocking that shot. He's right in front of the net. Bogosian, four and white, not feeling great. See him moving gingerly. Good defensive work there by Kopetsky, but it carries to Kane, who gets out. Vander Kane moving down the wing, centering pass, blocked away by Weaver. Kulikov, a good hit on Burmistrov. Kopetsky got a piece of that, and it'll carry all the way down. Panthers back at it. Thursday at home, 7:30 against Chicago. We'll have it for you here on Fox Sports Florida. Jovanovski couldn't clear it out. Kendall McCardle scoops up the puck, and a pad save by Theodore. Wheeler, Jovanovski on him. And Jovanovski took it away, found Skilly up ahead. He just gets it deep and gives chase. Skilly working the boards, back for Goodbranson. Back in the corner. And scooped up by Stapleton. Wheeler again. Offside on the Winnipeg Jets, a whistle.
The Panthers continue to roll that four lines. Blake Wheeler came over last season. Mike Santorelli back in action. I thought Santorelli's played well here at the start. That shoulder injury set him back at the start of training camp, and he's trying to find his legs, find his way with some new teammates. Big production last year, 20 goals from Santorelli, and now the expectations. It's a lot harder when you don't have the expectations to score 20 goals, and all of a sudden the big expectations are placed upon you. So see how Santorelli handles this season.
Enstrom carries in the offensive zone. Around the boards, Thorburn after it with Jovanovski. Kennedy joins in, got it ahead, Mathias. Nice feed for Bradley. Good job working the boards there by the Panthers. Mathias along with Bradley, but they couldn't track it down. Tanner Glass on the dump in. Garrison moves back, and Glass never got to center, so that's an icing call on the Jets.
Jason Garrison, it all resolved. For me, it revolves around confidence, but it's his slap shot. Watch him shoot the puck in practice, and no one shoots the puck harder. And I did ask him about it, and I said, you got the hardest shot on the team, don't you? And he didn't deny it. He said, he just flat out said, yes, I do. And you just don't see goaltenders get beat from 50 feet out. He's did it five times this season. All his goals from outside the top of the faceoff circle.
Faceoff win, Brian Campbell, who's just been setting up Garrison for those big blasts. Fleischman shoots, that was blocked. Garrison, five goals all of last season, has equaled that in the first 3.5 weeks of this year. Round the boards it comes, and just past Garrison.
Panthers are doing a good job in the faceoff circle, 58% in the first period, and a couple one draws in the second. They're getting a lot of time with the puck because they win the faceoff.
Fleischman flies in the shot, and that's in the midsection, and Pavlik will hold on to that one. Fleischman getting the shot away there.
And Thomas Fleischmann comes into this game on a four-game point streak, and it was a slow start to his Panther career, but that number one line are starting to click, and it's the chemistry with Weiss and Versteeg that has a lot to do with it, and a lot of his goals just go into the net.
He's added an assist tonight, so he'll make the streak at 5, and now 8 points in 11 games. Good numbers. Skilly, Santarelli. Around it comes, and Stewart will track it down. Santarelli knocked it down to the Atlanta line, or the Winnipeg line. It'll jump over into the Panther bench. My apologies.
We've had a standstill in the start of the second period. After a fast tempo, a lot of whistles to start the second period. The pace of play has come to a snail's crawl.
Weaver and Kulikov back on the blue line. The Gotch line up front against Winnipeg's number one line. Face-off win for Gotch. Antropov comes back. The big veteran, 6'6", 245. Nick Antropov, the former Maple Leaf. Already in 12 years now in the NHL for him. Loose puck at the end boards. Weaver winds it around. Oduya held it in.
Bit of an enigma, Antropov. Ups and downs, and a lot of talent.
Kane on the steal. Kane trying to get out in front. He does, but he couldn't get a shot away. And Kopetsky will get it out of trouble. Finds Kulikov, and up at the line, Upshaw. Funnels it in behind the net. Kopetsky and Oduya after it. Antropov plays it up the wall. Upshaw got a stick on it. Jovanovski on the pinch in. And the Jets able to work it free. Evander Kane, 20 years old, and the Jets carry in, but offside. 5 minutes into the second period. Reminder, it is Come Play Hockey Month, and Try Hockey, a free clinic at the Saveology.com Iceplex, Saturday, November 5th at noon, boys and girls ages 4 through 9. Good stuff going on at the Saveology.com Iceplex. The Panthers practice facility. Wheeler gets tied up. Stapleton there. Kennedy knocked it away. Wheeler again. He shoots it in behind the net wide. Carries to the point. Enstrom. Back for Wheeler. Looking in front. Only red jerseys there. Nice play by Kennedy. And he'll move out to center. Finds Bradley. Drop pass. Mathias. They're in onside. And the backhander up high. Pavlik to save. We're going to have a penalty called here. Penalty on the play. And the Panthers are going to go on the power play. It's going to be a hook as the Cats were driving the net and they drew the penalty.
Hooking call. And defense, offense from defense. Good positioning by Kennedy. Right in front of his goaltender as a center, you got to be able to help out his D. And that starts the transition the other way. Kevin Dineen said a lot of our offense comes from good defensive positioning. And that's the case. Good positioning by Kennedy. Starts the rush and then hard to the net, the hooking call.
Weiss, Fleischmann, Versteeg, Campbell, and Kulikov. Panthers came into the night fifth in the NHL on the power play. But Ladd jumps into the circle, able to push it all the way down.
The Jets penalty.
Ladd's trailed 2-0 tonight, 10 minutes in.
2 minutes.
And now with a chance to tie it. Campbell gains the zone. Down low, Versteeg out in front. Kulikov with a chance, but he sends it high. Oh, a golden opportunity. They set up Kulikov beautifully, but it carried up and over.
And the faceoff going to come outside. And it's a play by Fleischmann. Campbell is so good at rushing the puck up, gaining entry into the zone. Watch Fleischmann, number 14 in front. It goes right between his legs. You can't actually see it on the monitor, but he knew the pass wasn't for him and let it go to Kulikov. Kulikov misses the net.
Weiss on the draw with Slater. And Slater able to win it. That'll kill some valuable time on the power play with Kendall McCardle, the former Panther, in the penalty box. Little touch pass there. Fleischmann for Kulikov. Around the boards it comes. Thorburn with Versteeg after it. Campbell steps up, laid it to the corner. Stewart's clearing attempt was blocked down. Thorburn again. Versteeg nicely tied him up, but the Jets get the clear. And Kulikov midway through the power play. Right up the gut. Carries over the line. Dishes for Versteeg. Oh, that one jumped over the stick of Weiss. And Weiss will go off, as will Kulikov. Fleischman, cross ice, knocked down by Burmistrov. And now the Panthers get the full shift change on the man advantage.
Panthers have to get set up.
Santarelli throws it right through the slot. Kopetsky will track it down. Santarelli again. Kopetsky in tight quarters. Keeps battling using the big body. And got it up the point, Jovanovski for Garrison. Stern moved it around for Kopetsky. Try to get it in front, knocked down by Antropov. Kopetsky again. Jovanovski at the line. And Kopetsky turns on the forehand. Back for Jovanovski. Garrison, one-timer, saved by Pavlik. Garrison again getting a shot right on. Sturm around the boards. Garrison at the point. Power play is over. Santarelli, the give out in front, Sturm. But Bogosian knocked it away. And the Jets are able to kill it off. One shot for the Panthers on that man advantage.
From Garrison. Every time Garrison shoots the puck, you just kind of hold your breath. You expect every time to shoot it, the way that he's rolling, that it's going to find the back of the net.
Now everybody set him up for the one-timers. It's been Campbell. Jovanovski got into the act there. Feed the hot hand. Stapleton is in. Kane sends it right through the goal mouth. Thought for sure Kane was going to crank that up. Slid the pass right through the blue paint. Held in the zone. This is Blake Wheeler turning. Out in front, wide open is Stapleton, holding and waiting. And around the other side, Theodore scrambles back onto his skates. And Stapleton, after all that, never got a shot away.
Looked like he might have had an empty net after he outweighed Theodore, but neglected to shoot the puck.
Still in the Panthers zone, Wheeler, open man, Stapleton again. This time he shoots him, Theodore, with a big glove save. Scooped it off the ice, he's got it. 2-1, Winnipeg in the second.
At the Bank Atlantic Center at the Lexus Rink, 2-1 Jets here in the second period. Thomas, you got down two goals in 10 minutes, but have you had enough success believing in the system and sticking with it that it's easier to do it at this point?
Well, that's what we have to do because we are down, and we got one back on the end of the period, and now we got to chip in on power play and put one in and make sure we tie the game this period and win it in third.
All right, thanks a lot. Thomas Fleischman. Guys, it's Halloween, and if he was out trick-or-treating, he'd no doubt be the Flash. Back up to you, Billy and Goldie.
And no question, they call Fleischman the Flash, his nickname. Theodore made the save there off the draw. The faceoff will stay in the Panther zone. So after the power play, the Jets getting some momentum with some good shifts. Here's Bufflin's shot, deflected right onto the stick of Kennedy. He got it out. Enstrom with a nice little spin move. And he'll flip it in behind the net. Theodore out of his cage, played it around the boards. Comes back in deep for Ladd, looking in front, deflected away. Little up to the point, Enstrom. Back again, Little. And boards, Garrison stepped in front of Wellwood. And then Kennedy found a loose puck. Bufflin will slide down, big collision with Bradley. Played right in front, Ryan Campbell there. His clearing attempt knocked down. And Bufflin poked off the stick by Campbell, his former Chicago teammate when they won the cup a few years ago. Here's Sean Mathias moving in. Mathias out in front. Loose puck found by Kennedy. He'll turn. They give to Bradley out in front. Kennedy couldn't quite tee it up. Pass a couple of inches off the mark. Good look by Bradley, though. Jovanovski, wrist shot. That one got all the way through high. Good Branson. Trying to get it through to Kennedy. Enstrom takes away. Jovanovski pinches in. Leaves it at the goal line. Bufflin around the boards. Weiss on the shift change is now on and takes away. Ooh, the pass right up the slot. But in between to Branson and Jovanovski. Here's Jovo. Tipped over the line. Fleischman tracks it down. They give to Weiss. Fleischman again. Sending it right towards the net. Carries up to the point. Kulikov. Panthers buzzing around, looking to tie it. Fleischman, good Branson, slap shot, knocked down in front. Weiss tried to feed it to Fleischman that time, but it was stolen away And Kane hustles in. Sends it right in front of the net, hit the outside of the cage. Versteeg the other way. Trying to get ahead of Steve, shakes free from Stapleton. Fleischman absorbs the hit. And Stapleton took the puck. Kane with Wheeler. Wheeler's slap shot up high. Theodore had it all the way. Antropov stolen away by Weiss. Here's Mike Weaver. Up for Versteeg. Got it to the line, but knocked down by Oduya. Now Versteeg gets it deep in the zone. Hit the stanchion on the glass. Heads up play by Burmistrov. Oduya had some trouble, but Upshaw couldn't take it on the stick.
Oduya was looking where to pass the puck and never looked down and fanned on the puck. Upshaw almost the beneficiary.
Good hit by Garrison on Burmistrov. Antropov for McArdle. Burmistrov again. Comes in behind the Panther net. Burmistrov continues at age 20. First round pick last year. Here's a shot, never gets through. Another shot, this one does, but tied. Marcel Gotch under pressure, but he'll find an open man. Garrison looking ahead, Kopetsky trying to break in, but it caught the Jets' bench. And a whistle with 8 minutes to go. In the second, and the Cats looking to tie it. Well, they've got the lead on the road. They are the new Winnipeg Jets, the old Atlanta Thrashers. So where is Winnipeg? I've been asked that all offseason. There it is, up at the top of your screen. There's the distance from Sunrise, Florida, more than 2,200 miles. And we see that average January temperature of 9 degrees, home of the Royal Canadian Mint. There you go.
And 7 hours north of Minneapolis, that should tell you enough about Winnipeg. There are days where it's been minus 30, minus 40, and that I've been in that city, and they tell you, be very careful to go outside. If you do, you cannot stay out for prolonged periods of time.
We'll be there next week. We'll have it for you on Thursday night, Tuesday in Toronto, and Thursday in Winnipeg. Winnipeg in the offensive zone here. Slater looking for Tanner Glass behind the net. He was wiped out by Jovanovski. Branson then takes a spill, trying to get to the puck. The battle continues along the boards. Slater gets a hold of it and fires wide. Bufflin, Rister, well wide. Enstrom at the point. His shot gets through and a stop by Theodore. And now Jovanovski over to Gabranson. Skilly. Gabranson picks it up and he'll just finally dump it out of the zone.
Second period has tightened up. After that first period, saw a lot of chances, a lot of second chances, but both teams have buttoned down the hatches in the second. Pace of play has slowed considerably.
Here comes Skilly. Fleischman on his horse, sweeping in behind the net. Bumps with Bufflin. Fleischman nicely gets it free on the backhand. Weiss is there trying to jam it home. Free puck side of the net. Weiss now behind the cage. Weiss and Fleischman got it out. Here's Fleisch for Weiss again, but it's stolen away, and the Jets move 2-on-1. Bufflin has Ladd go to the net. The pass knocked down by Garrison. Bufflin again on the backhand. And Garrison for the Panthers, ahead for Fleischman.
Bufflin not too smooth, a 2-on-1, but bobbled the puck a number of times, and Stephen Weiss at the other end came dangerously close. I think Enstrom, the defenseman, might have got a skate on it.
Weiss and Fleischman, good down low. Stewart down the boards for Ladd. Andrew Ladd up to the point. Bogosian comes all the way back down deep. This is Antropov looking out in front, and it came out in front, but Kane could not handle it. 5:50 to go in the second. All the goals in the game came in the opening period. Wellwood and Kane for the Jets. Garrison is fifth for the Panthers. Campbell and Fleischman on the assists. Stewart and Bogosian work up the ice. Weaver back to cover. Kulikov off the glass all the way down. And Bogosian back again. Panthers put 20 shots on goal in the first period. The Jets have tightened it up. Panthers are now at 23. Lead pass too far for Kane. No icing as it carries on goal. Mike Weaver knocked down by Slater. Free at center. Kopetsky is there. He moves in, finds cross ice. Kennedy His shot is a stick save by Pavlik. Nifty play by Kopetsky, finding the open man right off the bench. Kennedy working in the corner. Behind the net, Matthias. Knocked away by Glass. Matthias returns the favor. Good hit by Kennedy. But now taken by Jones. He gets hit. Jovanovski steps up. Out in front looking for Kennedy. Knocked down. Oduya to center. Tanner Glass. Jovanovski ties him up. Two aside work. Bradley in there. Pinned to the boards and the skates. Everyone trying to use the leg muscles here. Still pin, check that out. And finally, we get a whistle and a stoppage with just over four to go in the period.
Welcome back to the Bank Atlantic Center in the second period. It is still 2-1 Cats, but they have certainly had some chances trying to use their speed to create some offense. Tonight's rush of the game is brought to you by Red Line Energy. It's defenseman Brian Campbell getting things done in the Panthers' own zone, using his speed to move through the ice, through the neutral zone, feeds it to Sean Matthias, who puts a shot nearly on that, can't quite get it off. But the Panthers have had some good chances here as they try to tie it up in the second period. Let's go back upstairs to Billy and Goldie.
Thanks, Allison. Scott Clemenson will join Allison with a second intermission coming up as we approach and hit the four-minute mark. Theodore gloves it down and hands it over to Jason Garrison.
Scott Clemenson on the ice today in the morning skate for the first time in quite some time, coming back from that knee injury.
Good to see. Clemenson, a quality NHL goaltender. Skilly with a big hit on Enstrom. And then Skilly gets hit by Bufflin.
Bufflin wants a piece. This should be an instigator against Bufflin. The big hit by Skilly, the glove drop. This has to be an instigator against Bufflin. So it should be a two-minute instigator. The big hit, no call on the hit by Jack Skilly. A perfectly legal hit. Enstrom felt the blow, and he was slow to get up. His defense partner, Dustin Bufflin, took exception.
And Skilly is actually down for a little while there. You know, that's part of the problem that I'm seeing now in the NHL, Billy. Good, clean hits. Yet the team that gets hit feels like it's got to go and fight after a good hit. There's no reason for that. That's
well,
a good hit.
Well,
you don't need to jump the guy.
You have the puck in the shoulder by Jack Skilly, and that's exactly what you want from Jack Skilly. Hard on the forecheck, and Enstrom reaches out for the puck, and bam! He get lit up like a Christmas tree. And then Bufflin with the reaction, but this is probably, this should cost Bufflin. You don't like the reaction, I guess, is the clean hit and the fight at the end, but this has to be a two-minute instigator penalty against Bufflin. When this all comes out in the wash, the Panthers should have a power play. So if you want to take those liberties, I'm okay with the response from Bufflin. Skilly's strong and able. He can stand up for himself. So if you want to go ahead and attack and take the extra minor penalty, the Panthers will take the power play.
See, we're seeing this all the time in the NHL, a good hit, and then somebody comes over to fight the guy that laid the good hit.
Yeah.
It's not a dirty hit.
But it's just the nature of hockey. You see something happen against your teammate and to stick up for him. And okay, so it sounds like we're only going to get 4 minutes to Dustin Bufflin.
As well, we should. There should be no penalty there on Jack Skilly at all.
No.
Didn't do anything.
It's a dumb penalty, I guess, on Bufflin. Claude Noel probably not going to be happy when he sees the 4 minutes go up on the board. But it goes back to being in the hockey game, the instigator. The instigator usually never gets caught, the retaliator all the time. So if you're the Panthers, that's good, clean hockey. You want to be the instigator on the play. Jack Skilly does his job, and Bufflin takes the 4 minute minor penalty. And this is textbook shoulder and Enstrom. Enstrom got in trouble when he reached out for the puck, and he was in a bad position. He was exposed. And Skilly just did what he has to do as a player in his position. And then the response from Bufflin.
So the Panthers are going to get power play time here. The 4 minute rough on Bufflin. And what an opportunity here for Florida. Down 2-1, 3:38 to go in the second.
If you're the Panthers, you'll take the trade off. The 4 minute. You say you don't like it. I like the response from Bufflin because it gives us a 4 minute power play. And a struggling team like the Jets, Claude Noel, bad time to take a 4 minute minor.
Draw the neutral zone. That's Brian Campbell on the left at the top of your screen. With Weissenberg, Versteeg, and then Fleischmann and Kulikov are back. Panthers 0 for 2 on the power play tonight. Dojan moves back. Knocked down, but now cleared all the way down by Little. Look out here, Andrew Ladd hard on the forecheck. Creates a turnover. Now Kulikov with Weiss, and Weiss will scoop it up. Weiss cutting in for Fleischman. Plays it off the boards, double teamed and hit. But gets it up to the point for Kulikov. Oh, look out, Ladd with a steal. Kulikov got back quickly. And then Fleischman steals it away from Ladd. They give to Weiss moving in. Weiss takes a look up, finds Campbell. Now the Panthers set up. Campbell along the boards. Campbell creeping in, over to Weiss. Kulikov straight on, takes a shot, deflects wide for Stieg. Got it back again for Brian Campbell. Walks the blue line, over to Weiss, side of the net. Holds. Here's a one-timer for Stieg. Stick save, Pavlik slid over. For Stieg again. Settled down by Campbell. Kulikov. Blast, saved by Pavlik, and he'll hang on.
Well, the Winnipeg Jets created a lot of problems for themselves. Andrew Ladd had the puck in the middle of the ice, tried for a breakaway. Kulikov gets back. Instead of sending it all the way down to the other end of the rink, Panthers get the turnover and able to get set up. Christopher Stieg camped out on that far side, but Pavlik over in plenty of time. Saw that goal the other night in Ottawa with the extra attacker for Stieg off to the side of the net for that one-time shot.
Santarelli with Kopetsky and Sturm up front now. Jovanovski and Garrison play the points. Cleared all the way down. 40 seconds left in the first of the double minor. And the Panthers call for an offside.
At a point in the game where your power play has to come through. The Jets have gift-wrapped a present for you. So it's important now, your power play, that 4-minute man advantage is almost a minute and a half in. Your power play has to be able to capitalize.
Santarelli with Slater on the draw. Slater gets tossed. In steps Thorburn. Able to win it. Big win there. We approach 2 minutes to go in the second period.
2 minutes.
Garrison up to center and then tipped deep into the zone. Oduya there with Santarelli. Now the Panthers with three on the puck. Able to work it to the corner. Marco Sturm. Up to the point, Garrison. And now Mike Santarelli moving in. Fake the shot. Garrison, the one-timer. Blocked in front. A lot of traffic. Santarelli moves in. He'll take a shot. Glove save by Pavlik. That was a good one.
Good puck retrieval by the Panthers. You have the power play outnumber the opposition. You said it perfectly, Goldie. Three players on the puck. They have two down in the corners that are able to outman them. That's what you have to do when you have the man advantage. You got to make sure you outnumber the opponents. It goes the other corner. Two Panthers again outnumber, and this creates the opportunity for the shot for the Panthers.
Weiss back out there with Versteeg and Fleischman. They get it back up for Brian Campbell. Here's Kulikov. Campbell. Fleischman moving in. Circles back. Campbell on the line. And rolls over to Kulikov. Spins it in deep for Stieg behind the net. Try to get it in front. It's solidly. Fleischman got it back for Campbell. Kulikov again. He and Campbell up high. Kulikov, and now Fleischman out in front. Weiss shoots, and it's blocked away by Bogosian. Good set up there. Fleischman down low for Stieg. Fleischman again. Fleischman finds Kulikov with a lane. Saved by Pavlik, and the rebound swept away by Stewart.
Some chances. Big block by Bogosian on Weiss.
Campbell, nifty, gains the zone. Still with it. Campbell now under pressure, gets checked. Comes around for Kulikov. Half a minute to go in the period. Steven Weiss out for Versteeg. Deflected in front. Free puck. They jam at it. Still no whistle, and now it's under Pavlik.
Frantically trying to shovel the puck across the goal line. Clock's still running here, so. Trying to feed that puck to the net and then just crash and burn. Pavlik able to keep the puck underneath him. A frantic melee in front of the goaltender. Bring out the snow shovels.
So 25 seconds to go in the period. There's the overhead, the good look. And a good non-whistle by the officials. They knew that puck was still free. Face off, Gotch will take it for the Panthers. And he wins it cleanly. Here's Garrison and Campbell up high. They were both under pressure. Good pressure by Little on the point man. Florida looking for one more chance late in the period. Upshaw at the goal line. Takes a shot, save, rebound out in front. Oh, sent right through the goal mouth. And Garrison shoots, knocked down in front. The Panthers came oh so close. Kennedy's centering pass came all the way through. The Panthers will still have 21 seconds left on the power play. We start the third period. The Cats are down a goal.
After 20 shots in the first period, the Jets able to button down the hatches. Only 9 in the second period for the Panthers. But a lot of those 9 shots, 4 or 5 of them, came late on that power play. On the power play, Panthers trying to take advantage. And this is the one off the side of the net. It's going to eventually work down. And I don't know if who is off the side, Campbell, ever sees the puck. If he's able to see that puck, he might have a tap in, but it just goes through the crease. So the Panthers trail 2-1. No scoring in the second period. A much tighter second period than we saw in the first.
Down a goal, going to the third. Still 21 seconds left on the power play. The Panthers locked in another tight one here at the Bank Atlantic Center Lexus Rink against the Winnipeg Jets.
Need more of that in the third period. The defensemen are going to have to activate on the rush for the Panthers. And again, Panthers are going to have to activate D on the pinch, down low, able to keep the pucks in. These are two examples of what the Panthers have to do in the third period.
All right, here we go in the third. The Panthers have 21 seconds left of power play time. And they'll try to quickly get into the offensive zone. And they do. Fleischman lost it. Picked up by Versteeg. Back for Fleischman. A chance. Saved by Pavlik. Garrison steps up. And now Versteeg in front for Weiss. Couldn't tee it up. Fleischman knocked away, but Campbell finds the puck. Fleischman again as the power play ends. In front. Weiss deflected on goal. Saved by Pavlik. Oh, a few more.
Fleischman and
chances.
Weiss twice. Excellent poke check against Steven Weiss. Knocked off his stick at the last second on the power play. Fleischman with a shot.
Well, Pavlik has come up big. 29 saves here in the opening minute of the third period. The Jets have the 2-1 lead. All the goals came in the first. Cats trying to get it even with Upshaw. Kopetsky fires Pavlik to save. Rebound. Upshaw got a piece of it. And now Kulikov at a point. Fires deflected by a Jets player in front wide.
That started from a turnover from Johnny Oduya. He's been victimized. He's been under fire for a lot of turnovers there up high.
Vermeestraw takes a shot. Theodore got that with a glove. It was Wellwood and Kane in the opening 10 minutes of the game. Then Garrison came back with his fifth of the year, leading all NHL defensemen. That came late in the first period. And that's been it for the scoring.
Panthers looking for some more magic in the third period here on Halloween against the Jets.
Weber tipped into the zone by Skilly. Santarelli gives chase with Stewart. Now Burmistrov finds Little at center. He has some trouble with it. And the Jets right back on it. Buffalin streaks in. Jovanovski leaned on him. Buffalin, the wraparound attempt. Oh, Buffalin was strong on that with one hand on the wraparound.
Runs about 240 pounds, and he's just able to shield off Jovanovski and uses the one hand. We got a fight in the middle of the ice. This time, Jack Skilly, their captain, Andrew Ladd, trying to solve the issue after that big hit. This time, Skilly's a willing dance partner against Ladd. Ladd not known for the fisticuffs.
Well, they obviously didn't like the hit by Skilly on Enstrom. And Ladd and Skilly going at it, and Skilly trying to get that hand free, did for a couple of moments. Ladd didn't take that helmet off with the shield.
Yeah, the bug shield is still in place.
And now they'll break it up. Both very tired, as you can see.
Well, that's the better way, if you don't like a hit, Goldie, to solve the issue. Instead of the immediate response, wait for a different part in the game to get back after Jack Skilly. This time the captain, Andrew Ladd, takes matters into his own hands. They battle it out to the bitter end. So Skilly's been in the middle of a lot of action. The big hit in the second period, and he has to answer against their captain.
So they're both all five each for fighting.
That's a much better way to solve it, Goldie, than the initial reaction that we saw from Dustin Byfuglien.
We'll remain 5-on-5 with the two major penalties. Kennedy in his own zone. Trying to get it through to Mathias. Couldn't do it. Garrison around for Campbell. Now for Bradley. Little touch pass. Didn't work. Stapleton moving in and shooting wide. No, Kevin Dineen doesn't want to see his team be that cute clearing the puck out of the zone.
Especially not the fourth line.
Here's Mathias absorbing the hit from two Jet players, but Garrison there to clean it up. Kennedy cleared it out. Too far for Kane. Garrison taps it the other way, but had too much mustard on it. It'll carry for an icing call. Saveology's deal of the day just got better. You can sign up for Saveology's daily deals today and get five Saveology dollars towards your first purchase when you use the promo code GOLDETV. Go to Saveology.com. Here's a good-looking hat. Both of those. I like you. You should have that going, Billy.
It's nice you dress up today. I came in the stick man costume.
Well, like you. She's got the blonde hair. All you need is the stash and the hat. You be right.
I don't think I can grow a mustache.
Draw in the Panther zone. Vermistrov got it back for Byfuglien. The big blast. Oh, Mathias went down for the block, and it carried out of the zone, so an offside call.
And if you're the Panthers, you got to look to players like Brian Campbell, Jason Garrison, the defensemen now are going to be critical for the Panthers, joining the rush, keeping plays in. They're going to have to keep to their game plans, but when they get the chance to go, the defensemen, they got to look to join the rush.
These two teams played six games last year. They were all decided by a goal. Panthers' last three have been one-goal games, so no surprise this is where we are in the third in a one-goal game as we look at Winnipeg getting down for a lot of blocked shots. Remember, the Panthers have 32 on-goal shots and 15 more blocked. So they've thrown a lot of pucks towards the Jets' net. For Stieg, nice drop pass. Weaver's shot right on, a loose puck, and they score! The Flash, Thomas Fleischmann, remains red hot, and we're tied.
Effect. Pinball wizard. Johnny on the spot. Thomas Fleischmann. Smoking hot. Good patience out of their zone by Kulikov. That play back to Weaver opens up the far side of the ice, allows entry into the zone. The no-look pass and then the Karam. There's a block that they attempted to, but it bounces right on the stick of Thomas Fleischmann into the empty net. Pavlik is out of position. Thomas Fleischmann, scorching hot, came into this game riding a four-game point streak, has points on both goals tonight, 6 points his last five games, and we are all tied.
Versteeg moves into the top dozen in scoring in the NHL with an assist on that one, and the Panthers down 2-0, 10 minutes in. Once again, they just stick with it, and they've gotten back to even. Fleischmann's fourth of the year and his second point of the night. Here's Stern getting it to Santarelli. And now Bradley taking Skilly's spot on this line with him in the box. Here's Jovanovski shooting pad, saved by Pavlik. And he's got it underneath the right pad. That's 35 shots for Florida now.
So Panthers with some momentum. And here's the play by Kulikov. Great patience up the ice. You can see him looking, but he goes back to his D partner. And back to his D partner, opens up that far side of the ice, and it allows the entry into the zone. Perfect breakout for the Panthers, results in the goal.
Weaver got an assist as well with Versteeg. Versteeg now up to 12 points on the season, as I mentioned. Tied at 12th most in the league. Panthers win the draw. Jovanovski back around looking for Versteeg. But Bogosian was there and got it to Oduya. Thomas Fleischman now up to 4 goals and 9 points on the season, nearly at a point a game. Versteeg finds the loose puck, drops it off. Jovanovski's blast right on, a rebound in front. Panthers couldn't get to it. Here's Versteeg. Panthers smelling blood now, looking for their first lead of the game as Thorburn funnels it all the way down. Good Branson back ahead of Glass. And he took the hit but made the play. Good work by Good Branson. Starting to see that talent that we knew Thomas Fleischman had. He's really getting comfortable now here in South Florida.
And a good all-around play. And that play that you saw from Kulikov back to the defenseman up to the winger, that's how you're taught to break that 1-2-2 trap system. They work on it all the time in practice, and they executed it perfectly to gain entry into the zone. And then the good fortuitous bounce.
Vermistroff in the corner. Panthers on it. Here they come. Gotch leads the rush. On the wing, but the Panthers in early. Offside the call. Nearly 5 minutes into this third period.
Mr. Big Time has been Thomas Fleischman. Last game up in Buffalo, Panthers were trailing 2-1. Thomas Fleischman able to tie it up 2-2. Garrison would get the game winner, and then tonight, same score, same result in the back of the net.
There are guys who just know where to be. They find the pucks in the open spots, and something the Panthers, obviously, we all know, have been lacking over the years. Well, that top line, your Marudi line to watch before the game, Billy. Once again, an outstanding. Fleischman gets the goal to tie it as we get a whistle and a stoppage, and Versteeg getting one of the assists.
And Fleischman's a player that had to play a secondary role in Washington behind Ovechkin, behind Semin. And he was the 20-goal scorer. He got traded to Colorado last year, was put in a prominent role, big ice time, 20 points in 21 games, and now number one line again here in Florida and producing at a point-a-game clip.
Kopetsky chips in. Bogosian had some trouble. Taken by Upshaw out in front, the got shot. He didn't get all of it. Stewart for Stapleton. And they get it up to center, and Kendall McCardle dumps in. McCardle after it. The former Panther wants a first-round pick of the Cats. Back at 05. Here's Stapleton. Battle at the end boards. And Gotch just would not be denied. Marcel Gotch doing the dirty work. Kulikov ahead for Weaver, plays it off the wall. And now Kopetsky at the line, but unable to deflect it deep in the zone. So Bufflin, nearly 6 minutes into the third. Thomas Fleischman, a couple of minutes ago, ties the game at two. Two aside, battle in the Panther zone. Kane with Matthias. Now in steps Marco Sturm and funnels it for Campbell. He'll start up and flip it in. Bouncing wide of the net. Sturm to the point, but it carries out of the zone.
And you start to believe in the team. You come back against Buffalo and you do it here tonight. I remember back in 96 when we were successful and we started to win, that belief becomes contagious.
Santarelli peels back. Feeds Garrison for the big blast. It deflects into the corner. Jones is checked and Sturm takes away. Garrison through Santarelli, but Matthias is there. Out in front, Matthias. Santarelli trying to swat it out of the air, but swing and a miss.
Strike one for Santarelli. Shortened up on the stick and tried to knock it out.
Trying to catch him in a line change. Santarelli tracks it down with some good hustle, but now he lost possession. Jovanovski, good step up. It rolls in front, but Bogosian the only man there. Weiss for Stieg and Fleischman. Back out for Florida. Taken by Wellwood. Now the feed in front. Big save by Theodore. Oh, a huge stop on Brian Little there. Jovanovski with a big hit on Oduya. Feeding Little again. And now Bogosian faked the shot. Two Panthers went down and Versteeg took it away. But it's held in the zone by Wellwood. Weiss on the back shaft. Versteeg trying to dig it free. Good Branson reverses it around, but held in the zone again. Weiss without a stick, the shot right on, and a blocker save by Theodore. And Fleischman will finally get it out.
First flurry we've seen in some time from the Jets.
Now things settle down. Bogosian stole it away by Kopetsky. Kopetsky keeps on moving, absorbs the hit. Still battling is Kopetsky. Finally he's knocked down, and fans wanted a cross check there, and it easily could have been one. Gotch takes away. Gotch finds Kulikov. And now down low, Upshaw plays it off the boards and goes behind the net. Scotty Upshaw. Kulikov again. The wrist shot was blocked by Wheeler. Kulikov right after it. Boy, what effort on this shift by the Gotch line. Kulikov and Weaver keeping the puck in the zone. Kopetsky goes down again, picked up by Gotch. He goes behind the net. Knocked away. Wheeler plays it up to the point. It's Kulikov again, and now Gotch again. Boy, the crowd really wanting a penalty. Three different plays. There could have been one called.
I'll take a goal. Just give me a goal.
Let's see if Gotch can do it on the slap shot. Deflected in front. Upshaw couldn't find it. It was right there in his skates. And finally cleared by the Jets.
Have we seen some dominance just by the Panthers back in the first period? And then another 45-second shift down in the Jets zone.
Now the Jets break in, but Thorburn had a roll on him. Backhander by Slater hit the outside of Theodore's net. Bradley able to dig it free. Held in at the point, though. The Jones shot, he didn't get any of that. And Brian Campbell wheeling and dealing, getting some space.
Shots are piling up. 36 now for the Panthers.
Bufflin couldn't hold it in. Now Bufflin moves. Bufflin controls. Blocked away by Kulikov. Held in again by Randy Jones. The slap shot deflected wide. Thorburn. Down low it goes. Slater with Matthias. Slater sends it in front. The shot by Thorburn just goes wide. Good work by this grinding line for the Jets. Slater again. To the point for Jones. His shot right on. Deflected up and over the net. Stays in play high off the glass. Panthers need a stoppage or a clear badly. This one deflects over the net. And finally, Kulikov gets it ahead. Matthias, and he'll get it out. Here comes Bradley. Two on one with Kennedy. Panthers looking for the lead. In front. And it goes wide as Matthias jumped up and joined the play. The Jets run the other way. What action here tonight. Antropov. Open man Bogosian. Saved by Theodore, and Garrison's there to clean up the rebound. The Jets hold it in the zone one more time. But now Garrison around for Weaver. He fanned on the clearing attempt around the boards. Two aside along the wall. Doug Free and Santarelli got it to the line, but again not out of the zone.
Game being played at a frenetic pace.
Clock continues to roll. Less than 9 minutes, to go in the third. Antropov keeps it alive again. Now Versteeg with some fresh legs.
Crowd now into it. You can hear the chants.
Versteeg to center, and he'll flip it in. Gets on his horse after it. Santarelli behind the net. Looking in front. Deflects over to the boards. Jovanovski out in front. Deflected on goal by Versteeg, and he stopped, and then he lifted it high. Versteeg right on the doorstep. He's got it again. Back down low. What a job by Santarelli. He's been out there for a while, and now the Jets get out with Brian Little speeding into the zone. Drop pass, Wellwood in front, shoots Theodore, got it at one. High with the stick for Theodore. Out in front again. Panthers trying to get a hold of it. Little trying to kick it to his tape. And finally, Kopetsky for Sturm. Open man is Jovanovski. Jovo moves in, sends it out in front, sticked away by Pavlik. Fleischman again. Kopetsky up to the point, knocked away. And back comes Winnipeg one more time. Stapleton in front, a man all over. Theodore with some robbery. He stopped Randy Jones with a pad save. Theodore keeps it tied with 7.5 to go.
River hockey, up and down we go. Back and forth, the goaltender's now putting on a show.
It is entertaining. Wheeler out in front again. It came all the way through the slot. Stewart, shot on goal, glove saved by Theodore, and we get a whistle.
Wild and Woolly here at the Bank Atlantic Center. Thomas Fleischman has the game time goal. We'll be back. Panthers and Jets locked in a good one, 2-2. Take a look at our Saveology save of the game. Right before we went to break, Jose Theodore stonewall Randy Jones. Theodore was going one way, but he had enough wherewithal to dart out with that left leg and make the save. That's our Saveology save of the game.
7:15 to go. Jets win the draw. Andrew Ladd, who's back from the fight with Skilly. Shot comes through, saved by Theodore on a redirection, and now we're going to get a whistle
and a penalty
call.
High sticking call.
Power play coming up for Winnipeg.
Florida number 7, 2 minutes for high sticking.
Kulikov, a late power play for the Jets. Number 7 at the bottom of your screen. Looks like Kulikov might have got hit in the face as well.
Second power play of the night for Winnipeg. They scored on the first. And off the draw, it's Bufflin up high. Quickly they get set up. Stapleton on the right side. Bufflin waiting on the blue line. Stapleton moves in. Cross ice feed. Wellwood back for Bufflin. Gotch and Upshaw, the forwards for the Panthers. Garrison and Weaver on D. The shot comes through, and Jose Theodore's got it.
Jose Theodore back in the game. We haven't called his name a lot. Jets have not had a lot of pressure, but that big save on Jones, and now a late power play for the Jets.
Theodore with 22 saves in the game. Panthers have put a season-high 38 shots on goal. Bufflin off the draw, takes one here, it deflects on goal. Theodore took a look behind him, but it's underneath him. And now Weaver gets into it with one of the Jets, and Garrison grabs Ladd.
Well, they've saved the best for last in this game. This is the old Winnipeg Jets against the Oilers or some river hockey back and forth trading chances, and Theodore almost had that one squeak between his legs. Theodore was unsure where the puck was. He's looking behind him. I think sometimes the goaltender just sit down if you're unaware. He looked and almost lifted up, left the puck exposed.
You know, the key here is Panthers need to win some faceoffs. It's Weiss and Little now. And again, the Jets able to control. Stapleton moving in. Gave it down low for Little. Behind the net. Ladd trying to cause the screen in front along with Wellwood. Comes through to Stapleton at the dot. He'll peel off to the boards. Stapleton holds. Goal line out in front. The shot by Little deflected into the corner. Wellwood tracked it down, and Bufflin couldn't hold it in. Kopetsky in after him. But Bufflin got back, and now Wellwood over the Florida line. Drop pass Ladd, goes through him to Little. The Bufflin shot deflected, and it goes up and out of play. 56 seconds left on the Jets' power play. 6:01 in the third, and we're tied. December 14th, check it out. Chris Versteeg and all the Panther players will be at the Ice and Dice Casino event at the Harbor Beach Marriott. Go to panthersfoundation.org, get your tickets, it'll be a great night. Another face-off here in the Panther zone. Gotch and Antropov, and it comes to the boards. Bogosian able to play it over to Burmistrov. Ryan Campbell gets a hold of the puck. Burmistrov knocked it down, but he fed it back to the point in between the point men. Bogosian being hounded by Matthias, but he lost his stick. Gotch trying to pick it up, and smartly plays it back for Campbell. Now Bogosian with half a minute left on the power play. Campbell, once, twice, and then on the third time, got it around the boards. Bogosian for Burmistrov. And Alexander Burmistrov works it down low. Antropov, bumped by Jovanovski. Now the work deep in the Panther zone, scooped up by Upshaw. And he'll just lift it all the way down.
Successful kill. Kulikov set to be released. 1 second. Played with a high stick. Whistle's blown, I think. Still 1 second. Kulikov sprinted from the penalty box. The timekeeper opened the door, and he beelined towards the bench. He's got to get back and serve his last seconds. But it's going to be a successful kill for the Panthers. Be 5-on-5 hockey with just over 5 minutes left. And shaping up. What a great, great third period we've seen from both of these hockey teams. No sitting back. Both these teams have gone for the gusto.
Kulikov's okay. They'll leave him on the ice here. Now they'll have a conversation about exactly whether or not Kulikov should be in the box. That's the delay. And the official Francois Saint-Laurent says, no, number seven's good. So Santarelli now out with Skilly and Sturm up front. Kulikov back at the point. And Santarelli probably try to draw it right back to Kulikov if he can. 5:06 to go. They got it back to Kulikov. His shot on goal goes wide. Weaver slides down. He and Glass cancel out each other. It's taken in by Santarelli. Kulikov back in behind the net. Sturm had it knocked away. And now Randy Jones settles things down. Garrison late in the first, made it 2-1. Fleischman here in the third at 3:13, tied the game. After the Jets got a pair in the opening 10 minutes. Here comes Santarelli again. He's had good jump tonight. Holding and waiting and finds Weaver with a big slap shot. That whistles wide. Kept in by Kulikov. Santarelli again shoots. Saved by Pavlik. He had Sturm right in his face. Skilly works behind the net. Backhander comes all the way through to the point. Santarelli one more time behind the net. Thorburn with the hit. Sturm able to get a stick on it. There's that season high for the Panthers. They're now up to 39. And Stewart has it for the Jets. Good. Kulikov with Weaver. Kane in on the forecheck. Fleischman now got it to center.
The defense hanging on to the puck, just get it out of the zone. Get a chance on your stick.
Bufflin at the point. In behind the net. Weaver there. Over to Versteeg. Fleischman's up ahead of the field. They got it to him. Weiss joins him with a two-on-two. Here's Weiss. Back for Fleischman. Look at the spin by Fleischman. Tied up now, and that's a penalty. Fleischman draws one late. Fleischman with a nifty move. Draw the penalty on Wheeler. 3:10 to go. Do not go anywhere. The Panthers are going on the power. Thomas Fleischman has that game-tying goal here in the third. The Panthers have had all different heroes this season in their six victories. Six different players have gotten the game-deciding goals. The Gotch won in the shootout. Garrison did it Saturday night in Buffalo with a late goal. And here with 3:10 left, the Panthers are going on the power play. There's Wheeler. Called for the hold on Fleischman. Weiss, Fleischman, Versteeg up front. They win the draw back for Kulikov. Panthers have not led tonight. Weiss for Kulikov. Weiss again. At the dot, moving in. Cross ice feed. He was looking for Versteeg, who would have had himself half an empty net. And so they scored late in the game in Ottawa a few days ago. Fleischman knocked away. Versteeg will play it. He gets bumped by Little. And Campbell at the point. Nicely holds it in. Got it to Versteeg. Knocked away. Campbell and Versteeg again. Trying to keep it alive. And they do. Steven Weiss. Campbell. Over to Kulikov. He'll go for Fleischman, who has a goal and an assist tonight. Kulikov straight on. Campbell again. Kulikov. Holding. Fleischman top of the circle. Versteeg trying to get camped out in front. Now he goes to the goal line. Fleischman has a chance in front. He scores! He rolled it! Oh, you gotta see this guy to believe it. He's red hot. And he gives the Panthers the lead with 2:10 to go.
The power play has been stagnant. But when you need it most at the end, flash of brilliance. They work on this up-high play as Fleischman, but it's the ability to stick handle through traffic in a tight space as he just weaves his way through. Pavlik back on the goal line and flash goes upstairs. The Panthers have a power play goal. Pavlik down deep on that goal line. No chance. Perfectly placed shot. Panthers with the lead.
First time tonight, Florida's got the lead. Fleischman's second goal and third point on Florida's 40th shot. They were down 2-0, 10 minutes into the game. After July 1st, general manager Dale Tallon was asked, who are you most excited about of everybody you brought in? He goes, Thomas Fleischman, he's got some talent. We're seeing it. Panthers now need to close it out. Upshaw shoots in. Oduya back. And we'll get a whistle here, and they're going to get the Panthers for an icing call.
And that's the high play that they work on up high to get it down, but it was Fleischman's ability to handle the puck in a tight space that made that play. He stick-handled three or four times in a phone booth, able to weave his way through traffic and get that perfect scoring position right in the middle of the slot. And then the wherewithal at the end to put it upstairs.
Kulikov and Campbell on the assist. We're going to get a timeout called here by the Jets. Let's look at it again, Bill.
We'll just watch the stick handling. There's three Jets around him, but he just weaves his way through traffic. And then all the confidence in the world and the celebration at the end. That was a pretty display. That's just talent. There's not a lot of players. You got to be able to have skill to be able to work your way through traffic. And Thomas Fleischman right now, that zone that they talk about as an athlete, he is in the middle of it. There's some diagram going on, talking about what they're trying to accomplish here in the last minute, 41 seconds.
How about Brian Campbell, another assist. He leads the NHL with 11 assists. The net is empty for Winnipeg with 1:41 to go in the faceoff in the Panther zone. There's Pavlik, who has played really well, 37 saves on 40 shots. So extra man on for the Jets. 6-on-5 off the draw. Comes over to the board. Kane to the corner. Garrison trying to dig it out of there. Played by Ladd. Andrew Ladd, the captain. Up to the point, Bogosian. Winds and shoots, blocked down in front. It's loose in front. And Upshaw plays it over to the boards. Ryan Campbell got a stick on it. Bogosian holds it in the zone. Now it's Kopetsky. The net is empty the other way, but Kopetsky flips it out. 1:10 to go in the third. Upshaw, Gotch, and Kopetsky up front. Garrison and Weaver on defense. Florida trying to make it 4 out of 5. And start the homestand with a W. Here's Ladd. Lays it around the boards. Bogosian waits at the point. Jack Bogosian, shot saved by Theodore, and then they score!
No goal!
They wave it off immediately! Touch with a high stick, says the referee, Tom Cole. They will go upstairs and to Toronto and take a look at it anyway with 49.9 to go.
But was it touch with a high stick, then a pass, or was it knocked in with a high stick? If it's a pass high stick, then there's no review. So I'd have to see, I don't know if it was knocked in with a high stick or it was played first with a high stick and then knocked into the net. If it was played with a high stick and then knocked into the net, it's not going to be reviewable. And there, that's the play with the high stick. And then from the angle down below, so there's a couple things that you would have to take a look at,
so
Goldie,
to me. So
you're
saying they're not reviewing the goal.
Well, I don't know. They might review the goal as well, but the review, you can't play with a high stick and then have your own player touch it as well. So there was two instances where Kane deflected that puck.
Well, they're ruling that before it was ever, the shot on goal was taken, that it was touched with a high stick.
Yeah, but I think that high stick, I think with Theodore playing it off his pads, and that nullifies. You're going to see the first initial, it was played with a high stick. It goes off Theodore's pad, and then two high sticks there. So,
I don't know. Immediately waved off. They've got to get conclusive evidence that it is a goal to overturn it. They'll talk to Toronto, the war room, where they review all goals in the NHL.
And goalie, if it's being reviewed, it's being reviewed if it was knocked in with a high stick. So they're taking a look at that last high stick play by Kane. The rule is that the stick has to be below the crossbar. Played with a high stick there and then knocked.
Well,
it looks
close,
to be above.
The Kane one's close.
Well, let's see here. Let's take a look. If you can stop it there at the peak, guys, stop just right there. It has to be lower. If I can draw a line from that crossbar, that's basically the height that you're looking at. It's almost dead perfect. So that's from that angle on the telestrator, it looks to be almost dead even.
Yeah, the Wellwood one was okay.
Yeah, the Wellwood one looks to get back over. And the best look that we had was that last look. I think that the look before this that you gave us guys downstairs was, I think, the best one that you could come up with. This one here from that angle. And just, again, you just you're looking at that height of the crossbar out to there. It almost looks to be just dead perfect.
Well, it's got to be conclusive to turn it over. It was ruled no goal on the ice. Again, 50 seconds left. The Panthers have a 3-2 lead on Winnipeg.
And I think that's the key statement. I don't think there's enough evidence to rule it one way or the other. I think that the official call on the ice is the one that you have to go with. Because if I draw that perfect line to the puck, it looks like it's dead even, but it's not enough evidence to tell me 100% that it was or it wasn't. So if I'm reviewing it, I would have to go back to the initial call that was made on the ice.
Kevin Dineen waiting, as the Panthers are, for the official word. It is close.
I'm going to go with no goal just because not enough evidence to overturn it. That's my call. I'm sticking to it. We'll see what happens. You never know.
No, they look
it's
like
close.
They look like they've made a decision. We'll get the announcement.
The original call on the ice, after discussion of the Panthers box, was goal. It's confirmed. It's a good goal.
Well, they give him the goal.
Now, they said that the initial call on the ice was goal?
It wasn't goal. They were waving it off initially.
But that's, is that what he said? Did he say we went with the initial call? It was a good goal on the ice? Okay, so they've determined it was a good goal. It was right at that borderline height of the crossbar, and they elect to go with it. The Panthers don't catch a break.
Wow.
We're tied at 3.
Fleischman gave the Panthers the lead at 17:50. And a minute 20 later, the Jets tie it. Here we go again. 40 to go. Campbell on the dump in. Stewart gets back. Hounded by Versteeg. They clear it out. Garrison hustling back. Garrison played it up the boards. Look out here. Nick Antropov deep in the Panther zone. Now it's Wheeler. Had his pocket picked by Campbell. Bogosian takes a shot. Campbell swept it away. They've got Fleischman up ahead of the field, but they couldn't get it to him.
Good.
And now under 10 to go. Panthers will shoot in. Cats and Jets both have themselves a point. And we will go in overtime. More late game drama from the Florida Panthers. And we are tied at 3 after 60 minutes of play. Overtime is coming up. After Thomas Fleischman with 2:10 to go gave the Panthers their first lead of the night, but the Jets with a goaltender pulled and 50 seconds to go on a double deflection. Got one by Jose Theodore, Andre Pavlik. He's faced 40 Panther shots tonight. Panthers have gone overtime one time this year. They won in the shootout against Tampa. Meanwhile, the Jets 0-1 after regulation time. Jason Garrison, Brian Campbell have been prominent tonight. They'll start on D. Santarelli with a strong game tonight, earning himself overtime play with Kopetsky. Ryan Little for the Jets. In over the line. Santarelli stole it away. Starts the other way. Has Kopetsky with him. Oh, but Santarelli just couldn't quite handle that rolling puck.
Puck blew up on him. I think his head was going faster than his stick, and he lost control.
Now Santarelli with a head of steam. Blue line. Red line. Had it back checked. Knocked away, but Santarelli recovered. Ryan Campbell now as Weiss jumps on. Along with Kulikov and Versteeg. Here comes Brian Campbell. Panthers looking for a game winner in OT. Versteeg down the wing. Kulikov jumping up. Holding and waiting. The give to Campbell. The shot is blocked and it carries all the way back. The race is on and Versteeg will beat everybody. And again it's Campbell at center. And again up ahead. But Kane cut it off. Kane with 2 goals tonight. Carries down the wing. In behind the net, out the other side. Stewart on the blue line, takes a shot. That one missed. And Mike Weaver for the Panthers. Looking for some space, nicely. Weaver skates free, finds Fleischman jumping on. Thomas Fleischman couldn't control long enough. 3:25 to go in OT. Jovanovski over to Garrison. He'll take a shot that's blocked. And Garrison recovers. Now Garrison starts through center. Hammers it in on goal. Sticked away by Pavlik. Oduya after it, checked by Scotty Upshaw and stolen away by Upshaw. And now Garrison over to Jovanovski. Garrison again, winds it around, looking for Fleischman. Bogosian, though, able to play it. Blake Wheeler to center, he'll dump in, and the Jets will get a change. Jason Garrison. Now Gotch is on the ice, along with Tim Kennedy in overtime. Boy, does Kevin Dineen use everybody. Campbell, nice move, gets over the line. Nice move, maintains possession. Campbell throws it in front, it comes all the way through and sticked away by Pavlik. Boy, this open ice, watching Brian Campbell is something else. Little for the Jets. Back checked and picked away by Gotch, beautifully. Kulikov, now to Kennedy. It rolls over the line, Randy Jones peels back. Nearly 3 minutes into overtime, and no whistles. Bufflin gave it away at center. Kulikov jumps up and shoots in. Kopetsky after it. Working along the boards is Kopetsky. The Jets get it free to Bufflin. And now Kulikov will move back.
The beauty of 4-on-4, wide open. No whistles. We're almost 3.5 minutes into the extra frame.
Kulikov moves over the line. This puck deflects. Kopetsky gets shoved from behind there by Stewart. Jets break out. Kane has trouble at center. Now he settles it down. Kopetsky knocked it away. Here's Stapleton. Flipping it towards the Panther net. Ryan Campbell. Fleischman and Weiss are on, and here they come. Steven Weiss. Now Fleischman, who has two tonight. Fleischman holding. Fleischman. They give it to Dot. The shot comes through, and a save by Pavlik. Campbell for Fleischman straight on. Caught a feather one through, stolen by Stapleton. Less than a minute to go in overtime. Stapleton finds Bufflin jumping up. He takes a shot clock save by Theodore, and then another one by Theodore with 46 and a half seconds left in overtime.
Big save by Theodore down at the end to preserve the tie. Bufflin is dangerous. He had a bunch of game-winning goals, overtime goals last year when they were the Thrashers here up the middle.
Face off to Theodore's right. Antropov pushes it behind the net. Kulikov is there. Antropov pounding Kulikov. Now Marco Sturm is out there. Weaver lost it to Antropov. Trouble here. This is Jones throwing it wide. Bufflin hands it over. This is Jones firing, glove save again. Jose Theodore comes up large late in overtime.
Well, the pressure, the shots have come from the Jets late in the period. 17.8 seconds. Reaches out with that right hand. Theodore catches with the right hand. Most goaltenders catch with the left. Big face-offs now, and Gotch is going to lean in and take an important one.
17.8 seconds to go. Gotch wins it. Back for Campbell, but Ladd able to get a stick on it momentarily. Garrison, nice cover. Here's Brian Campbell, and it comes out to center. Kopetsky will look for one more chance. It's Gotch with a second to go, and they won't get a shot away. Meanwhile, Kopetsky got hit hard, and he is hurt. Kopetsky slow getting up and will move over to the bench. That's the last thing the Panthers want to see late in overtime. He has trouble getting off and gets to that Panther bench. The shootout, Theodore against Pavlik. Panthers Jets next. What a game it's been. Kane with two goals for the Jets, Fleischman two for the Panthers, and the shootout is coming up after Kane got it tied in the last minute.
And I want to explain to you what happened. The Situation Room does a great job informing us. They send us an immediate email, and what happened after this play is Tom Cowell, the official, got together with his other officials, the immediate wave off there. But what happened is they confer on all goals and get together. So all the officials got together, and what they determined on the ice was that it was a good goal once they all talked about what they had seen. So they get together, rule it was a good goal. They go back to the video room, the high stick, they determined that it was a legal goal. So the goal that was called on the ice, if you go with that, they determined that it was a good goal. I would have to say that the evidence that we saw, you had to go with what was ruled on the ice. So the situation room gets back to us, explains it in full detail, which has been great help for us. They rule it a goal on the ice, and it stands, and that's why we're in overtime and a shootout.
We get the sheets being handed over for which shooters, both Claude Noel, the Jets coach, Kevin Dineen, the Panther coach, will utilize. Panthers won their only shootout this year, and Versteeg will start the shootout. Mike Santarelli, remember his first year last year for the Panthers, he's good at it. He was hurt for the first shootout, he's healthy now, so Kevin Dineen will use him second. And then Steven Weiss will be the third shooter. Stapleton will start for the Jets. Andrew Ladd.
Oh, you remember the only shootout that we had, Theodore was perfect, 3 for 3, and just stonewalled the opposition.
Against Le Cavalier, St. Louis, and Stamkos.
Who? That was a pretty good three. So he's up Stapleton, Ladd, and Wellwood. Not in the category of the three that you just mentioned, but as you go in the shootout, you just never know. That first goal is important.
Panthers trying to get the 2 points here. Stapleton, very limited opportunity, has been is 2 for 2 in his career. Good effort tonight by the Panthers, who found themselves behind 2-0, 10 minutes in, battle back. Grabbed the lead briefly late in the third before the Jets tied it. Stapleton in on Jose Theodore. And Theo wasn't fighting.
Theo sticks with him all the way. Tried to go to the backhand and kind of rolled off Stapleton's stick. The late pump, the fake, but no bite from Theodore. Just stuck with him the whole way.
Versteeg quickly scoops up the puck and flies in on Pavlik. Oh, nice glove save, Andre Pavlik on Chris Versteeg.
Got in too tight. He was in too close to the goaltender. Once he tried to get it upstairs, he was right next to Pavlik's glove. There's no room for Versteeg to get that puck airborne.
Andrew Ladd, that's about the average, about 30% when you look at 25-30% when you look at penalty shots and shootouts. Ladd races in, and he beats Theodore down low, and the Jets have the first goal of the shootout.
The pull drag to change the angle as he comes down on his forehand, and he's going to tuck it into his body, which changes the angle against Theodore, and he puts it into that low left right-hand corner.
Santarelli has been outstanding. There it is at 50%, well above the average. And here comes Santarelli trying to even it up. No.
And once he started to make moves, the puck started to oscillate back and forth and makes the moves, and the puck starts to bounce on that second move. And
Wellwood could end it here. Theodore is trying to keep the Panthers alive and give Weiss a shot. Kyle Wellwood in on Theodore. To the forehand, he tucks it in. And the Winnipeg Jets win the shootout. And they get the 2 points and a 4-3 victory. A thriller tonight. The Panthers get only 1 point.
Back and forth. Lots of ups and downs between these two hockey teams. Panthers trailed 2-0. They clawed their way back. Got all the way to a 3-2 lead. They had three unanswered goals, but late goal by Evander Kane, a goal that was reviewed, gets the Jets into a shootout, and they win it on a goal by Kyle Wellwood at the end. And this time Theodore bites on the fake. Wellwood goes the other way, and Theodore can't reach out with that leg. So a game that was in the grass for the Panthers ends up in an overtime loss, their first overtime loss of the season. But all in all, from being behind 2-0, Panthers with a good game overall, but fall just a tad short.